Well, welcome to day five of the World University Games athletics program here in the Stadio San Paolo in Napoli. The men's 3,000 meters steeplechase. Rocaparnate back to see if he can complete that trip to the top of the podium. Ali Messaoudi of Algeria was on the medal podium back in Taipei as well. No Algerian in this final though. Well, there he is. Rocaparnate of South Africa goes to the Northwest University in Potchefstroom. Silver medal last time out. He also was in the 1500 meters in Asia 2 years ago, but not quite so successful, although he did reach the final. He's not the fastest man in this race either on PBs. That goes to the the inexperienced Moroccan Mounam Sassoui, who's albeit 24. So away we go then. It's just under 7.5 laps of the circuit. The reason why it's not exactly 7.5 is because, as you will see, they are going round this first time. They go round the water jump, which is on the inside of the track. Most of the modern water jumps are on the inside. You do still get the occasional circuit track which has the water jump on the outside. But straight away going into the lead is Araui Sayaguchi of Japan. Goes to the Tokai University. And personal best this year in winning the national championships in Fukuoka in June. Fastest into the final here today. But four more men have better personal best than he does, including Sassoui, Smeaton, Degagne and Stevens. We'll come to them as the race progresses. So you can see the Moroccan there very much in contention. 8:51.36 he ran in the heat. This is his first international championship, the man who goes to university in Fez. 24 years old, down to 8:22 this season. They hit the water jump for the first time then. Just seven more to do. And it is still Sakaguchi who leads at the moment from the Moroccan Sassoui. And not surprisingly, Mokopane from South Africa, not too far behind. Mokopane, who went to the African Championships in 2016 and got to the final there too. Ashley Smith is the other South African, just 22 years old, in his first international championships. Just on his shoulder of his more experienced teammate there in third and fourth, respectively, the two South Africans. The Australian that you can see, Matthew Clark. There's another one, Max Stevens as well, both 24. Stevens won the national title back in April in Sydney. In 8:39, you've got a personal best that's another 10 seconds faster than that, but the Japanese here is pushing them around. Still leading there in single file mostly, except for that front four. Title won 2 years ago in 8:35.88. His title in the past has gone to the likes of Martin Grau of Germany and Igazia Safulin of Russia. Shenzhen champion saw a change of nationality where the Portuguese Alberto Casemiro Paulo took it in China. And at the moment, it looks like a Japanese is taking on the rest of the field here in Italy. Still the Ryoi Sagakushi, 22 years old, goes to university in Harasuka-shi. World Junior Championship experience as well in the past at 1500 meters. And he's going along a nice clip at the moment. Four laps to go, 70 second lap. And the Japanese at the moment still looking the most comfortable. Ashley Smith in second place at the moment. And the Moroccan also there as well, Sasui. And who goes to the Sidi Mohammed Ben Abdullah University. Is looking very, very good at the moment. Very different style to the compact, rather busy-looking pace of the Japanese in front of him. It's a much more languid and leisurely stride from the Moroccan right behind him that looks very good at conserving the energy as you get into this latter part of the race. They're beginning to get split up now. The front five now beginning to pull away. The two South Africans still very much there, and joining the party is Jean-Simon Degagne, the Canadian. Smeaton also there by the looks of it. Smeaton, though, just beginning to drop off there with his long hair. And it's still Sakaguchi. It'll be two laps to go when they come round to the line for the next time. And Sakaguchi has been unable to break the men behind him and has just dropped the pace just a little bit. Five men in touch. Degagne looking like he's dropping off. And Mokopane there is at the back of that front five. So then the scorer down at the finish line changes the marker to just two laps to go, and it's still the same man that's been in front all the way through the race so far, Ryohei Sakaguchi. But he's just slowed it up as they come to the first hurdle of the next lap. Sasui still looking very threatening. He goes in front, in fact, now. Ashley Smith still looking good. Sasui, though, running well. Now the Canadian beginning to suffer. These two now beginning to get away. Mokopane needs to pull his socks up. Back in fourth place at the moment. And the Japanese, who looked so strong just a lap ago, has suddenly blown it. Sakaguchi now dropping off the back. Had one of the better personal bests of the runners here, so it's a little bit surprising that he's struggling so much. Sasui then leading at the moment. They will hit the bell this time. It's down to gold and silver now. South Africa in second and third. Sasui, who was fastest in the heat and is showing his pedigree here in the final. He goes for the long haul. 500 meters from the end, he broke. Now he's still in front and he's pushing it all the time. South Africa at the moment, still second and third. It might well be just the minor medals for them. But Sasui of Morocco is pushing hard. He's keeping his legs high, pumping his arms. A little look behind him there, just to see what was happening. And now Smith is beginning to struggle. You can see his head just going there. He took that hurdle very heavily indeed. Sasui now coming to the water jump for the very last time. He'll have 150 meters to go when he lands on the other side. Sasui is going to take this, I think. No one's going to take him here. Sasui is going to do it. Mokopane finally gets it together. And the man who was silver medalist last time out looks like he's going to take it again here. Can he get there? Sasui is beginning to tread water. Needs to go. Oh, my goodness me. He's going to get him on the line. Sasui gets it. Wow. Well, he was just playing with them, apparently. What a finish. Well, if the South African had that inside him, left on the last 80 metres, why did he not push it earlier? Well, Makapane there, that is bewildering. Silver medalist 2 years ago, by less than a second, he's done it again. Less than a second. He lost out to Zielinski 2 years ago of Poland, and now he's lost out to the Moroccan Mounam Sassoui. And the student from Fez has completed his first international championships in stunning fashion. Well, again, we've seen a race tonight where the athlete that went off hard in the front just served to be a pacemaker for the rest. This time it was Sakaguchi of Japan. He looked very comfortable until the last two laps, and then just suddenly everything just disappeared from his legs. Sasui, though, a very, very good run. And the man from the land of Said Owita, himself, who has been a star in the past of the Universiade, comes across the line, but by word, he's looking up at the screen to see whether or not I think he can just celebrate and take it easier. Makapane absolutely sprinted down that final straight and nearly got him. Look at this. Makapane's not even in shot. He's just almost jogging here. You think he's got it. He thinks he's got it. He thinks he's so far in front from looking at the board and the TV, and then suddenly he realised Makapane's coming. So confirmation then of that splendid victory in the 3,000-metre steeplechase for Mounam Sassoui ahead of Ranzo Alfred Makapane, who misses out on gold by a second for the second Universiade in a row. Third place going to Ashley Smith, the bronze medal winning run in 8 minutes 33.6.